Well, folks, you may have seen this antique axe from Southern Africa that I showed not long ago, and I was looking for someone who would be interested in making a reproduction of one of these that I can use for testing, which I don't want to do with this one here. And, well, that has happened. This is what I got in the mail today. So one of my subscribers happens to be both an anthropologist and a blacksmith, and they offered to make a reproduction. So I took the measurements of this, and the blade is really identical. You can see, you know, same length, same width, same shape. There are some differences here, which I'm going to show you in a moment. The most important difference for some of you, I bet, is going to be the little extra feature that he added to be able to end them rightly. Yeah. It's got a pommel. It's unscrewable. It's throwable. It also came with a note, which looks awesome because it's aged and distressed. That looks pretty cool. It says, "Greetings, Skellagrim. Encloses your new stabbing axe from the For Honor Forge. It was inspired by Tsonga, Venda, and Zulu axes used prior to and during the colonial period, and is similar to axes found in the archaeological records of Great Zimbabwe. It was forged from mild steel and doesn't entirely follow the original way of making the sort of axe, but this is an experimental blade and we are more concerned with the overall shape and use of the blade. Likewise, the handle is made of a mulberry branch and reinforced at the top by a natural knot in the wood and below by linen coated in gorilla glue in lieu of sinew or rawhide. The handle may be fitted heavier than the original, but its increased diameter should fit your hands better. There's also an added pommel of doom to rightly end the critiques of those who wrongfully sneer at weapons they are unfamiliar with." That is very useful. "May it ever aid you in your epic journey, whatever your quest may be. Be sure to wield with honor and courage and commit yourself to never harm thy friend or thyself with a stray blow from your blade. Sincerely, Stephen." Thank you very much, Stephen. The really awesome thing is also that he made this for free. He didn't charge anything for it. So all I had to pay was the import fee. Let's look at the differences here. So as I said, the handle here is thicker than this because this is really oddly thin. This, on the other hand, is definitely more substantial and fits my hand better personally. But of course, since it is a branch, it's a little crooked compared to this one here. I don't know yet if this is going to mess with the edge alignment. It might, depending on how it wants to move. So I may have to rehaft that at some point, but we'll see about that. The blade is very, very similar. The only difference is the tang on the original is thinner. You can see it's quite a bit wider here, and it goes all the way through and is then bent up like this. Whereas this one here is, it looks like it's cut off right there. And well, obviously this has got a pommel. And I think this wood here might not be ideal. I don't actually know anything about mulberry in particular, but I see that it's already cracked right here, so this might break with use. No big deal on a reproduction. You can always rehaft it, which on an antique, that would bother me. Edge is pretty good. I should probably sharpen that a little bit more. But I think it's actually pretty close. Well, it's a little sharper than the original. The original isn't terribly sharp anymore, probably. I'm guessing that it used to be sharper. Either way, so this I can actually, you know, go crazy with and use on, you know, ballistic gel dummy and things like that to see how it goes. I might even try some tatami cutting with this, with such a long edge, that might actually work pretty well. And we'll see how it goes. Since it's mild steel, I probably shouldn't be too rough with it, but yeah, I'll just do some tests when I get around to it. I don't know yet when that's going to be, but you'll see it, obviously, on the channel. In direct comparison, this one here has quite a bit more heft. It's noticeably heavier than this. The original is really remarkably light, kind of lighter than I would expect for a weapon like this, and maybe also lighter than would be ideal. With the extra weight of this one, you can definitely strike harder, and at the same time, it's still fast enough that you can, or light enough that you can be fast with it, I should say. So yeah, definitely looking forward to trying it out. So thanks again, Stephen. Highly appreciate it. I'll leave a link to his website down below, so you can check that out. And I also quickly want to show you something that is now available at Purpleheart Armoury, a Genunting trainer. So here is the Genunting that I have from traditional Filipino weapons. And let me just get that out. So you can see that is very close. It's pretty much identical. Of course, the trainer is going to have to be thicker. It's not wider though. And yeah, it's exactly the same length, grip length and everything is very, very similar. Pretty much identical. It's of course lighter. The nylon doesn't have any give, so it can't be too heavy because otherwise it wouldn't really be safe to use in sparring. This should be perfectly safe with protective gear if you're going fairly intense, or light sparring without protective gear. Well, I would always suggest gloves and a fencing mask or helmet, something like that, with a visor. But yeah, this seems pretty decent. Definitely like it. Also very affordable, so if you practice Filipino martial arts and are looking for a trainer, I would definitely recommend checking this out. And they've also got this now, which I would have never expected to see as a synthetic trainer, a maquitl. At least that's what I've been told how it's pronounced. So if you haven't seen that before, it's an Aztec weapon. It's essentially a kind of a paddle-shaped wooden sword with obsidian blades glued to it on the sides. So that's kind of cool. I would definitely suggest wearing decent protective gear with this one, because this thing is gonna hit hard if you swing this with force. And it's quite a bit of mass here, and it doesn't really have any give. There's barely any flex in it, and of course it has no give, you know, towards the edges. So you should be careful with something like this. But and then also the problem, of course, is if you want to reconstruct Aztec fighting methods, I don't think there is much of anything to go by. I've never seen anything myself. Now, they certainly didn't have written manuals the way you had in medieval and Renaissance Europe. Maybe there are some remnants of the ancient art in martial arts that are practiced in that area nowadays. But either way, it's just kind of a fun thing. And wouldn't mind messing around with that a little bit when I get a chance. And finally, if you're interested in this shirt or other channel merchandise, I'll put a link in the more info section. That'll give you 15% off. So that's all I've got for right now. Thanks for watching and have a good one. A Genunting trailer. Trailer? A Genunting trailer. Okay. I'm just gonna go look for all the traditional Filipino weapon trailer parks. That's gonna be fun.